Greetings from Bermuda, this is BDA Limey, and welcome to Inscryption, a game that may or may not be a deck-building roguelike, a horror game, or an escape room game, or some combination of all of those, or none of the above. Let's jump in and find out.
Okay, time to figure out what's on this thing.
Okay, there is no option to begin a new game. All we can do is continue, look at the options, credits, or leave. So I guess we will continue. Not at all creepy. Another challenger. It has been ages. Perhaps you have forgotten how this game is played. Allow me to remind you. Play the squirrel card. Now, play your stoat. Stoats cost one blood. Sacrifices must be made. Goodbye, squirrel. An honorable death, lay the stoat. Wolves require two sacrifices. You don't have enough. The bell to end your turn. Commence combat. Your stoat stands unopposed. Number on the bottom left is its attack power, 1. Your stoat dealt me damage. I added it to the scale. You win if you tip my side all the way down. Like this. My turn. Your stoat stands in the way of my coyote. Coyote dealt 2 damage to your stoat. That means your stoat's health is 2 less. If a creature's health reaches 0, dies. It's your turn again. You may draw from your deck, or you may draw a squirrel. Dull. Play the squirrel as well? I should play the squirrel. But. Are you going to make me? I don't want to sacrifice the stoat, though. Look at the stoat. Here we are. You. The wolf demands 2 sacrifices. Fear not. The beast is sacrificed, but not removed from your deck. Its suffering was real, but you will see it again. If I put it there. The coyote's gonna kill it, so I'm gonna put it there. Oh, I ring the bell, don't I? I probably could have done that and not killed the stoat. Sorry, Mr. Stoat. 3 damage dealt. 3 weights on the scale. Because you are learning, I will pass. Again, the choice. A random card from your deck. Certainty of a squirrel. The snapper needs 2 sacrifices as well. End. I've got more attack than you do, I can win. You've won this match. It won't all be so easy. Let me recall your story. Oh, yes. You were lost deep in the forest. A single path revealed itself. 2 denizens of forest approached you tentatively. The undying cat. Sacrificing the poor beast does not kill it. The caustic adder. Damage from its poison bite is always lethal. One may grace your paltry deck. Well, I chose the adder in the demo, so let's go with the cat. Another creature joins your caravan. Some of the creatures of the forest seemed willing to follow you. You came across an abandoned sack. You found a squirrel in a bottle, break in case of emergency. And have a second. Another useful implement. It'll allow you to tip the scales with it. Three is as much as you can carry. You were ambushed while crossing some rough terrain. You sacrificed me while I was sleeping. It was the right play. I get it. Maybe you'll help me. Play along for now. You may see my moves ahead of time. Hey, so he's kind of putting the wolf cub on this row next go. Okay, and the boulder will block him. I guess we need a squirrel. And I guess if the cat is undying. Oh, no, we gotta do a sacrifice to get the cat out. But the cat's got zero attack. Okay. Behold the rule book. Indeed. Leap card bearing the sigil will block an opposing creature if bearing the airborne sigil. Okay, alright, so we didn't need to worry about all this stuff just yet. Alright, are we just going to put the stoat out and sacrifice the squirrel? I think we are. Here we go. And we are going to ring the bell. Find the ambitious wolf cub. It ages swiftly. Take a squirrel. Okay, so the bat is gonna fly over me, I think. He's also got 3 health, so that's fine. So we can put a squirrel down like there. And yes, we put the cat down. Unless we had to piss blood to put the cat down, but okay. We could put the river snapper down, but then we'd have to sacrifice the stoat, and I don't really want to do that. That just feels harsh. So, well. The airborne bat flies over creatures to attack directly. Okay. Yeah. Ha! My bat flew right over your stoat. I better take it on the squirrel. Gonna need to sacrifice 2 things. But I don't want to do it this turn. I want to do it next turn once he's killed that. Then I can put him in front of the wolf. So I think I'll just wait. Okay, so yeah, the stoat attacks him. I can attack flying creatures. Sure, let's take something from my hand. Okay, so wolf. Attack 3. Fence 2. So, I'm trying to remember how this works. I think they attack on the turn that we put him down. So, sacrifice the squirrel and the cat and put the wolf there. Oh, right, the cat actually stays on the board. Okay. I didn't realize that. I thought he came off and then we had to get him back on again. Okay, that's good. That helps. Ring the bell. Yes. Yeah, we get in an attack first. Okay, another squirrel then. Squirrel goes down there. And then... is any benefit of getting the snapper out now? I guess we may as well. Sure, sacrifice those two. Put him there. And ring the bell. And we win. You prevailed and trekked onwards past the now bloodied terrain. The young wolf cub rose into a wolf after a single turn. A meek sparrow, an inexpensive if feeble flying creature. I like the idea of the wolf cub. Nice and fairly cheap to play. And then, yeah, the wolf is strong, so. Sure. You stumbled into some strange stones in the mist. You're compelled to choose a worthy sacrifice, one that will be lost forever. Cat, the wolf cub. But he just started playing with a cat, so sorry, Mr. Wolf Cub. I haven't just got you, but you're gone already. Wait, what? Pick me? Stoat wants me to pick him? You sure? Really? Oh, no, the Stoat's... okay, we're picking the executioner. The Stoat is going to execute the wolf cub. What an honor. Oh, that's right, okay, it gains its power. A ghastly spectacle, but the soul of the wolf cub now lives in the Stoat. I could have made the Stoat undying. That would have been cool. Alright. Behold, my totem. It inscribes my canine cards with the airborne sigil. He's completely insane, you see that, right? No care for the rules. Pathetic, really. Enough! Keeps me around. Watch me suffer. Alright. Squirrel. Hang on, what's coming on? A flying coyote, okay. And a flying bat. Okay, well at least that means they won't attack me. So... I won't attack my creatures. So we can do that there. We can put the cat, I guess, over there. And then we can get the Stoat in. Sacrifice the cat, put the Stoat there, back on the board. Have you forgotten the items I gave you? I kind of have, but I also haven't needed them. So I'm totally fine with that. And we can't get the wolf out unless we sacrifice both of those. So ring the bell. Totem has granted my coyote the power of flight. Now he has the power of the wolf. So squirrel down there. Play the wolf, sacrifice the cat and the squirrel. Put the wolf there. And ring the bell. Let's take a card from our deck. Okay, we can't afford this unless we sacrifice something, so we'll hang on to it for next turn. Well, that was a lot of damage. You're 3 damage away from winning. 4 damage away from winning. We'll take a squirrel. Put the squirrel there. We can play the river snapper by sacrificing the cat and the squirrel. The only problem with the cat, I guess, is once it's down... it's down. Oh wait, no, maybe this will replace it. No, it won't. Nope, nope, can't do that. Cat is there to stay. I think that's fine. As we won. Impressive. May yet survive this ordeal. Knock on wood. An adder, a sparrow, a river snapper. A stalwart snapper, a near impenetrable defense. I don't know what this is. Is that telling us we already have one of these in our deck, maybe? I'm not big on the snapper. They're a bit expensive. Where is the adder? Then we can have the adder and the cat. Let's take the adder. And we can either go sacrifice stuff. Go that way. Let's go sacrifice stuff. Who are we going to say? Oh, we're only given a choice of two. The cat or the adder? So I guess this gives our undying power to somebody. Which is pretty good. So we could give that to somebody that's got more than zero attack. The cat is going to be sacrificed. Who do we want to be undying? Does that mean that they can't be killed by enemies, or is that only when we sacrifice? What does the rulebook say? I don't know. Don't know. Is that all expensive? Is the downside? I guess. If we put it on the snapper, then assuming he can still take damage and be killed by enemies, he stays on the board for the longest amount of time. Although he's also the one that I don't really want to play that often. Nah, let's put it on the wolf. Put it on the wolf. Onwards. There's a way out for both of us. It's somewhere in this foul cabin. Be silent or I will tear you to shreds. Okay. Squirrel. Too late. I have put that in the wrong place. I definitely put that in the wrong place. Wait, if I sacrifice the squirrel, can I put the stoat there? Can. The spot, you sure? I mean, I guess he would block the grizzly if you went there. But then you die. Can I even undo you? Can I move you? I can't even move you. You're down. So, I guess I am sure. I can't do anything else. Ring the bell. I think I'm going to lose this. Take 4 damage. Wait. We can put the adder out. Take that. Squirrel there. And then adder. Okay, Stoat, you've been sacrificed. I'm sorry. A bit done. Seriously, yeah. Then done. Nice. A serpent perhaps more deadly than man. A death touch, basically. Oh. Wait, what? I lost? Whoops. How did I lose? Using this as a learning opportunity may be the only way to mitigate my disappointment. Get up. Get up from the table. Fetch me the candlestick from atop the barrel beside the door. Okay. WASD to move, and we're turning at 90 degree angles. It's a little getting used to. Okay, candlestick, cheer. Do some other stuff first. Can I interact with anything else at this stage. I missed a ton of stuff in the demo. Possibly not. Okay, fine. How do I sit back down? I'm gonna sit back down. Going forward, but it's not doing anything. Oh, I've got to give him the candlestick. There we go. Now sit back down. Okay, so. Let me explain something to you. That was one of the two mistakes you can make here. You make another. Sacrifice you. Now, where were we? Eek. Let's go that way. What this icon is. An elk. A flighty elk. It moves after attacking. Bullfrog, the watchful bullfrog, it leaps in the way of attacking flyers. Conniving raven, a blight upon the skies. I like the fact that the bullfrog is cheap. Let's take him. Can't take more than three items and you have three. Instead, perhaps you'll accept this gift from my friend. Okay, pack rat, sure. The prudent pack rat. Never doubt the utility of a well-stocked pack. Not seen this card before. Alright. The trees seemed to close in around you as a chill mist descended. In the distance, you could hear the clinking of metal on the stone. A hobbled figure stood in your path. Yee-haw, 'twas the Prospector! He's doing the Prospector again? Easy, boss. Mule's key. Hey. So, what does the pack rat do? I know, but I want to know what. Oh, right click, tell me what that does. Trinket bearer, when a card bearing this sigil is played, you will receive a random item as long as you have less than three items. Okay. I should use my squirrels in a bottle, probably. Okay, what's he doing? It's got a 2-1. What can I get out? Get out the wolf. Well, I better get out with Stoat, actually. The squirrel there. Stoat there, who will survive. Okay. I suppose I could get the pack rat out now. Do I really want to do that? Two. The wolf is a 3-2. I could just get the wolf out now. You know what? Let's do it. Squirrel. I guess there's 3 damage on him right away. And then we'll play the pack rat next turn. Well, that's 4 damage with the stone. Squirrel. Okay, alright, so he took 2 damage, but then he did his evolve thing, which is good. But this is going to try to move, but it can't move, I think. Oh, is it going to move over here? I'm not quite sure. bummer that we can't get the pack mule. Without sacrificing the stoat or something, which I don't really want to do. Yet. So... I think I'm actually just gonna keep what I got. Did I neglect to mention overkill damage? You did. Excess damage is not wasted. It carries over to the card behind the mangled corpse of the victim. Lucky for you. And we win. Oh, no. I hope you didn't think it would be that easy. He has two lives as well. There's gold in them cards. Okay, I still don't really want to play anything, so... Wait, what? What? What are you doing to all my cards? Gold, I've struck gold. Oh god, okay. That's a slight problem. I could do two squirrels to get the packer out. Except I can't because the gold nuggets are in the way. Oh, can I sacrifice those? It looks like maybe I can. Take a card from my deck then. You know what? Let's try and get the packer out. Can't draw blood from a golden nugget. You'll need something else. Oh my god, okay. Can't do anything then. So I can't do anything until these golden nuggets are out the way. Wait, can I put cards up there? Can I put them in his area? Nope, cannot. Shoot! I don't remember it being this hard last time. I guess then I can't do anything, can I? Shoot, ball. Okay. He's at least cleared the way for me. Let's get another squirrel. What's that symbol there mean? When an opposing creature is placed opposite to an empty space, card bearing this sigil will move to that empty space. Okay. He's a 2/3. What have I got that can do 3 damage? Absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. But I do have a river snapper which can take some damage. I guess. Card from my deck. The bullfrog. Not super useful right now. Just hang on to him. Bonk off the adder. Okay. Let's take that. Sacrifice two. Wait. No. And bullfrog. Sacrifice the squirrel bullfrog there. I don't know whether I should be focusing the pack mule. Well, it's probably alright. And unless I want to sacrifice both of those, nothing else I can do. So, that's it. Now the mule can move. Let's take a squirrel. Is he bringing in another adder? Let's do a squirrel and then replace the bullfrog with a pack rat. Okay, another pair of pliers. Turn. Yes. I should take something from my deck. Okay. Do I sacrifice both of these? I do one to him, he does one to me. Okay, so the pack mule actually moves back. Yeah, what does this symbol mean? When a card bearing this sigil is sacrificed, it does not perish. Okay. Okay, scrolling. No, we're going to take one damage. We'll put the squirrel there, the wolf. And we'll get rid of the snapper. Squirrel, put the wolf here. And in the turn, should win. Yes. Allow me to light your candles once more. I won't be killing you quite yet. You're the first in a while to overcome a boss. As a reward, you are granted an opportunity to select a rare card. Choose carefully. Really? This level of brutish strength needs no explanation. Oh my god. 7-7, but 4 blood to play it. A largely unimpressive specimen, a strange lava. It's going to evolve into something. To a more powerful form. You don't know what the more powerful form is there. Poor abandoned child. It does not die when sacrificed. But do you have the heart to try? 13. Okay, so that's kind of like the cat then. I'm thinking the strange lava surely must turn into something good. This is just going to be too hard to play. So yeah, take that. With sound of the Prospector's pickaxe still ringing in your ears, you carried onwards. The rank smell of rot and mold permeated the humid air. Every step forward was answered by some nearby slip or slither. Tread cautiously into wet land. Now, can I get up from the table at any time? I can. Feel like there ought to be something that we can do here. So, I mean, we don't have sufficient information yet. So we could set this clock to a particular time. That is safe here. We can presumably find the combination for somewhere. There are some little models. Something that needs a key. Dagger that I cannot take. Okay. And what kind of can't do anything with it right now, I don't think. And stuff on here that I can't get. Okay. Alright, fine. Let's continue. Three cards. The river otter. Ah, the elusive otter. It submerges itself during my turn. Which could be a bad thing, because it's not going to be able to block anything. The regal moose, the creatures of the wild, make way for it. Hefty. At the end of the owner's turn, a card bearing this sigil will move in the direction inscribed in the sigil. Creatures in the way will be pushed in the same direction. Okay. 7, that's pretty beefy, but it needs 3 sacrifices. One card bearing this sigil submerges itself during its opponent's turn. While submerged, opposing creatures attack its owner directly. Yeah. Okay. And another adder. Don't want to go for a more expensive card. Take another adder. Taking an adder, I could always sacrifice it later as well to give something else death touch. Feels like it's better having more smaller creatures out. I don't know. Hit that. Okay, so this gives us some equipment, and we do have one space now. Oh, this will do the sacrifice. Okay, so let's go this way, actually. If we get the choice, we can sacrifice the adder. Got 2, so yeah. Sacrifice the adder. And give death touch to well, the river snapper seems pretty good because it will just stick around. Yeah, do that. Okay. Squirrel. Ah, what's coming? Bullfrog, okay. I want to see what the strange lava does. So let's get that out. Done. Range pupa. God, it's going to take multiple turns. Roll. Alpha, what is this? Leader. Creatures adjacent to a card bearing this sigil gain 1 power. Okay. I guess we would like to kill the bullfrog, so let's put that there, get the stoat out. The squirrel, put that there. Total misplay. Okay then. Opinionated stoat. Go. Wait, what? Why do you go to 2? Oh, because, right, he's buffing his attack now, isn't he? That was a total misplay. Mothman! Attack 7. With flying. So surely that's an instant win, isn't it? It's like an instant win. So I think we'll do nothing. Wait, we are nearly dead though. Actually. But I think we're good. We're close. Okay, but we get 7 again next go. Take another squirrel. I guess the rattler is going to do more damage to us, so we should kill that. How brutal of you. You dealt me more damage than you needed to win. However, in my game, such feats are rewarded. To be precise, a tooth to keep for each extra damage dealt. Trapper may be interested in your spoils. See, we will meet him at some point. Okay, onwards. River Snapper? Grizzly, the monstrous grizzly. Its form speaks enough of its efficacy. It's pretty powerful. Beehive, the inviolable beehive. When it is attacked, you draw a bee. Bees within. Once a card bearing the sigil is struck, a bee is created in your hand. A bee is defined as one power, one health, airborne. And doesn't require a sacrifice. That would be great. Let's have one big boy in our hand. I worry a bit about how playable he is, but maybe we could sacrifice him with a cheaper card, and maybe that would give his stats to the other cheaper card over there. Or maybe that only works with things that have. If you deem it necessary, you may cut up one of my cards with these. Oh, okay. Choose one. Oh, I'll take the scissors. Feeling overburdened enough with the full three items you carried on. Oh, right, okay. Yeah. I just better go for the pack. Okay, fight. Don't know what that is. Let's go find out. Everything got death touch. Everything has flying. Better defense against flying. Okay, squirrel. I did quite like that strange lava. So let's get that out. And that's basically all we can do. The death touch thing's gonna kill me. Oh. Okay, well, in that case. Big squirrel. Oh, what a pain. Yeah, so he's gonna come onto the board and attack and just kill it. So, given that, I might as well sacrifice it. Get out pack rat, but then if I'm gonna do that. Whoa! Ow! Well-earned points of damage. I had to take one of my teeth out to do a point of damage? Oh my god. I didn't think you would really do it. Well, I wouldn't have done it if I'd have known. I was just making room for the pack rat when he comes out. Okay, where's he gonna go? Oh, this buffs the damage. I guess I need to get rid of bullfrog thing first, so squirrel there. Pack rat, sacrifice both of those. Ow. This is not good. Need a card for my deck. Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all. Am I dead? I think I'm gonna be. I am definitely dead. No! No! I could use my tools, but I think I'm just completely overwhelmed. Oh dear. That's sad. Sacrifice me. How disappointing. God. Okay. That was a fairly comprehensive defeat. What's that? Looks like a trap. Maybe that was like an elite fight. You were stopped along the way by a trapper looking to liquidate his pelts. There was something uncanny about his appearance, but you were quickly distracted by his wares. Care to look at me pelts? Take a pelt, free of charge. What, any of these free of charge? See the quality? Oh no, I think he gave me a rabbit pelt free of charge. Wait, what does... what does that even do? You're leaving already? No, I'm not. No. Please consider me pelts! Okay, I will. Just clicking on it, I don't know what it would do. It's like a leaving thing. Golden pelt, 9. How many teeth have I got? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, let's get a wolf pelt. Oh yeah, okay. That's 5, so yeah, 7. I don't know what the pelts do. I take as many as possible. Sure. Done. Thanks for your business. The man assured you of the value of the pelts. Appeared to be useless in a fight. But he mentioned that the trader further down the path would reward you for them. Oh dear. Oh no. So they've just gummed up my deck, basically, is what he's saying. Okay, so we'd probably better not sacrifice a creature then, because we don't want to empty our deck anymore. However, if we go this way, we've got another elite fight, which is probably going to kill us. What's the campfire do? I can't remember. Go on, let's try it. You came across a small group of survivors. Faces shrunken from starvation, they huddled around a campfire. They looked upon your group of creatures and beckoned. Come. Warm one of your creatures by the fire, one said. Warm it by the fire, will enhance its power, said another. You noticed one of the survivors wiping drool from their mouth. Plus one what? What am I giving these things? I have a lot of expensive cards in my deck. Stoat, go on. 2-3, okay, increases its attack power. The fire warmed the poor Stoat, enhancing its power. One of the survivors reached toward it, another gnashed their teeth. Without a word, you pulled the Stoat away from the fire and left. Okay. Elite fight. At least I'm assuming that's what it is. Okay. So the pelts are useless. Oh my god. 3 friggin' enemies. So that's gonna tempt me for 2. That's just gonna fly over me. So I guess what I can do actually is I can put the lava out next to one of the flying creatures. Oh, and it ducks as well. So because he's flying, he's not going to damage me. Then when this thing grows strong, I'll be attacking it for 7. So that feels like a good move. Wait, can we put the rabbit pelt down? Oh, we can put it down as a blocker, maybe. Yeah. Okay. Let's do that then. feel. Am I in trouble again already? I'm three away from death. One, two, three. I don't think I can win. Okay. Extreme measures. Pull another tooth out. And then cut up the coyote. Which feels like a waste, but... And then... I wonder if I can use a... Can I use a squirrel to block? Well, I probably can't use a squirrel to block because they're flying. That at least stops me from dying. So... Go. God. Okay, finally. Squirrel. What's coming out? A river otter. Which is attack one. Or all attack one. So, squirrel. Squirrel. Wolf. There. Yep. Mothman is great. I guess we'll take a card from our deck. He dead. He's dead. He is dead. Okay, good. Got some teeth. Like a computer monitor. You encountered a small outpost in the woods tended by a mysterious woman. It was the trader that the old trapper had mentioned. Her appearance was unsettling. You were mollified by her offerings. Do you mind if I examine those pelts of yours? Let's start with your hair pelts. Here's what I can offer. I can trade you any of these. Take your time. Okay, we would like some cheap stuff. Rabbit hole. When a card bearing this sigil is played, a rabbit is created in your hand. A rabbit is defined as 0 power, 1 health. Occupying sharp quills. Once a card bearing this sigil is struck, the striker is then dealt a single damage point. Skunk. Creature opposing a card bearing the sigil loses 1 power. Whoa. And then only the ones that we know. Feels like the skunk could be useful. Take that. Okay, it's 1 rabbit pelt each. Okay, well, I definitely want to spend those pelts. So... I did get rid of my cat. Let's get one back. Oh, wolf pelts too. Exquisite. Okay, so I guess an upgraded version. What's this? Bifurcated strike. A card bearing the sigil will strike each opposing space to the left and the right of the space across from it. Okay. Funky. And dives underwater. It's cheap. Trinket bearer. When a card bearing the sigil. Okay, random item. It's pretty good because he's pretty cheap. Oh, the beehive. What's that? Sprinter at the end of the owner's turn. A card bearing this sigil will move in the direction inscribed in the sigil. Okay. Or a wolf cub with flying. That's cheap to play. That's going to become a 3-2 with flying. That seems pretty good. Let's take that. These pelts are most excellent. My thanks. Okay. We could get an item. Can increase the power of one of our cards. Let's increase the power of one of our cards. A group of starving survivors stood around a dying campfire. There was room for a creature, and the fire one said, "The warmth will enhance its power," said another. The survivor said nothing at all, but could not stop licking their lips. I don't know whether at some point this is going to change, and they are actually going to eat my creature. I'd kind of like to give the strange larva some power, so at least it can do something while it's gestating. No way. Does he know what's coming? Is something bad coming? Let's do that. The power of the strange larva was enhanced by the warmth. As one of the survivors began pulling a knife from their pocket, he withdrew. Okay. Okay, we only have one life. Second boss. A foul smell invaded your nostrils and caused your throat to seize. A hulking man sat by a brackish pond with his feet submerged in the dark water. He pulled a hook from a pile of rotting fish and rose to his feet. I am the angler. Go fish. Right. What's he doing? Kingfisher. The flying and gonna dive out the way. But my bullfrog can counter that, which is good. So, squirrel. And bullfrog. Done. Oh, so he actually blocks it and takes the damage. Okay. Well, that's fine. Which fish? Hard choose. What does that mean? Okay, need a squirrel. What's he doing? What's he doing? He's going to do something with his hook to my bullfrog. Okay. So you can't now, can you? Because you killed it. Another squirrel. Is he still going to do something with his hook? He's kind of hovering it menacingly. Feel like I should. Get out. Squirrel. Oh, he's moved his hook again. What you doing with your hook? Fish, easy chose. Wait, are you gonna just kill whatever I put out now? Because that would be really super annoying. Going there, I want to hit him. Take new fish, easy. Oh no, don't do that. Aha! At least I defeated you once. Oh geez. Too fast, too soon. What has he put down? He's cheating. He's cheating. Gonna get a squirrel. This seems grossly unfair. such a bad sport. What? That is total cheating BS. Huh, go fish. Dead yet. This isn't purgatory. Think of it that way. Before you expire, I must ask you a favor. I would like a memento. Your very own death card. It's quite plain at the moment, isn't it? We will work together to amend that. I want this to be the perfect memento of you. Here are some cards from your mediocre deck. We can put them to good use. Please, choose a card to draw the cost from. Okay, so one cost card. What am I most likely to want to keep? One cost. A cost of one blood from the cat. And another. This time I will use its power and health. Numbers. Grizzly. 4 power and 6 health from the grizzly. Now choose a card from which we will extract the sigils. Something that I can sacrifice. And it won't die. Yes, that would be good. I need to get greedy, making it more powerful. Don't really need death touch when you've got 4 attacks, so yeah. A sigil of many lives from the wolf. I never did ask you your name. I am BDA Blimey. There is now but one final matter. The portrait. Are you ready? Do not need to smile. Go again. Another challenger. Perhaps it is time. Perhaps you can understand. Oh. The resourceful opossum costs 2 bones. You gain a bone when one of your creatures perishes for any reason. Okay. Bringing out a rattler. B1. Stoat. With the death of your creature, you gained a bone. Okay, let me sacrifice it as well. You will not lose this until it is spent or the battle ends. Okay, that is all we can do for now, though. Does hit hard. Okay, we better take that. And we better sacrifice the stoat to get the wolf out. When I was asleep again? Sorry. I had no other choice. No choice at all. But now I can play the opossum. Oh, the rattler's gonna kill me. I guess I better take a card. Bullfrog. One, two. I guess if I could kill the... is it worth killing the... he's gonna die, but at least he's gonna block 3 damage, so... And he'll do 3 damage as well. So, what's that? Okay. Wait, I got no more cards in my deck. Do you have an emergency squirrel? But I'm only 2 away from winning. So if I do that, and then that, should be good. Where's my figure? Oh. I forgot your figurine. Get up and fetch it for me. It's beside the safe. Ah, that's what those things were. Is that mine? Can't take one of the others. Anything else that's... Oh, hello. This now has stuff in it. Squirrel and a mantis. Why are they in there? Do I want to try to play that during a game? Get a squirrel in that position and a mantis in that position. Seems kind of obvious. I don't have a mantis, so that makes life hard. But maybe we can do something about that. And change it here. Can't get that. Have we ever tried to look outdoor? Doing. Oh, there's the rule book. I can now page through. Hang on, 273. Seems like a very obvious code. Anything else in here? Go with the obvious for now. 273. Two, seven, three. Aha! A stink bug. Oh, hello. I wasn't sure if I would ever escape that iron crypt. Is the stoat around? Stunted wolf? This madness must end. Put that away. Key. Key? Can I get the key? Why can't I pick up the key? I know something that needs a key. Why won't you let me pick up the key? Don't know, but it worked. Guess we try that again later. Let us continue. Indeed. But not right now. Continue next time. So, until then, thank you for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. And this is BDA Limey signing out. Bye for now.